Hello, Aries people. How are my beautiful Aries doing? It's your girl, Miss Hawaii, here doing your general love reading. I hope all is well with you guys, okay? I'm going to be using a special tarot deck today. I'm going to be using the Starman tarot. This picture be driving me crazy. Sometimes it be looking crooked. I don't like that. It's straight now, okay? Okay. Y'all know what it is, Aries. Roll up. Hey, mama, you want to say hi? You guys say hello to my sick little kitty. Say hi, Kelly. Hi, Kelly. Hi, Kelly. My little diabetic kitty, Kaylee. She's a good girl. All right, so I'm going to be using the Starman Tarot. Okay, it's pretty cool. Very cool images. A lot of people have said a lot of good things about this deck. A lot of positive things as far as the accuracy. All right, let's see what we got. I got the Manifest a Miracle candle burning for you. I got the Love Sage burning, and I got my Love Incense. All right. Make sure it's not burning too much. Sometimes it'll burn all the shit out. Hold on, Aries. I'm coming for you. Sometimes I just have to put this out a little bit because it starts smoking too much, this sage. Keep it. This shit don't stop smoking. Okay. That's fine. So let's see what's going on with my beautiful, wonderful Aries people, okay? Using the wonderful Starman deck. Okay, Aaliyah, try again is coming on. It's a sign there. My songs always give me messages when I'm doing my readings. That's why I have my music on sometimes. What'd you say? So maybe you're trying to, or somebody is asking you to try again. Try again in love. Spirit is telling you to try again in love. I'll keep it low. If I say no, hey, would you turn away? Go. I'll play me y'all. Oh, or would you stay? Oh. Y'all know about Aaliyah, y'all. Y'all know about this Aaliyah shit. Dust yourself off and try again. Hey, you could dust it off and try again. Try again. Hey, if at first you don't. Come on, Aaliyah. My shit. You can dust it off and try again. Hey, dust yourself off and try again, again. I run to you. Hey, you run to me, but I can't let it go so easily until I see if this could be eternity or just a week and your chemistry. Hey, is off the chain. It's perfect now, but will it change? This ain't a yes. Hey, this ain't a no. You do your thing. This is how we go. If at first you, oh, yeah. Come on, lover. I don't know if YouTube gonna ban my video because I played music. You're not supposed to. First you don't succeed. Y'all know I always break rules, though. Try again. Come on, try again, again, again. Get all the way on that first day. What about the next day? Come on, Leah. Lover. All right, let's see what's going on with my Aries. Since these cards are so big, I just kind of twist them all up like this. Y'all see I got a big-ass burn mark on my table? Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm, that was the sage. Mm-hmm. It fell, and I didn't even know. Mm-hmm. Y'all said, this girl, man, this girl. I love y'all, though. I don't give a fuck about this table. I didn't even use this table until I started doing readings. So it's like, dust yourself off and try again, and again. Yo, I had to get some people told today, yo. Leaving all types of crazy comments and shit on my page, like, not with it. One person telling me, oh, I was chewing. I took 10 seconds to take a piece of candy. Get off my dick. Other person talking about, oh, stupid shit, y'all. Anyway, let's get to your reading, Aries. Let's clear out that negative energy. What's going on in the love life of Aries? Please show us how Aries is currently feeling in love. This flew out. King of Pentacles. Ooh, with the Star Man at the bottom of the deck. This is the special card in this deck. This is like the Magician card in this deck. Okay. So you feel like the King of Pentacles, Aries. This is beautiful energy. This is Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. You could be dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, but I feel like this is you. I feel like this is your energy coming in. You want something stable. You want something secure. You are a provider. You're a nurturer. This is all you right here. This King of Pentacles energy. This is beautiful energy. This is being in your power, coming in your own, knowing how to handle what's around you. Hold on, let me put some of the sage out, because this shit's smoking like a motherfucker. Hold on, guys. Had to open the door. It's smoking up like a mother. I think I started a fire up in here. Sorry, guys. Hold on. Hey, kitty. Ride like a bro, ride like a bro. Much better. It was too fucking smoky in here, yo. Alright, sorry about that, guys. It was almost a fire up in here. Alright, so like I was saying, you're feeling in your King of Pentacles energy. This is awesome energy. You know, this is being about your bread. This is being about stability, wanting something secure, wanting something stable, not wanting to play no games. You and your king energy. If you're a woman, you and your queen energy. You know what I mean? Masculine or feminine, doesn't matter. You know, but this energy is about coming into your own, okay? In the book, it says, I have mastered the art of success. Okay? It says, stable and tenacious, sometimes a workaholic, refined aesthetic, commitment to the path you are on, respect and value the items in your charge. Okay, so that's beautiful energy right there, all right? So let's see what else Aries is feeling in love. How else is Aries feeling right now in love? Nine of Pentacles. So you're single right now. Okay, you're single right now, and you're independent with the Nine of Pentacles. You're doing your thing, making your money. You're very, a lot of people are attracted to you right now. You're looking good. Star Man again at the bottom of the deck. Came up reverse, so some people could be seeing you as manipulative right now. Or as a trickster playing mind games with them, okay? That's also more earth energy, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So you could definitely be dealing with an earth sign. So for the Nine of Pentacles, it says, I am in charge of my destiny. You are in charge of your destiny and what you believe you deserve. Know your gifts and accept them. The time is now to manifest your dreams into this world. With the Magician card, like I said, you had at the bottom of the deck. So this is great. You're manifesting, you're making money, you're looking good, you know your worth. Your energy feels really good right now. Let's see what else is going on. How else are you feeling in love? Show us, please, how Aries is feeling right now in love. Or that could be the way you're seeing the person that, you're thinking about. But I really feel like this is your energy right now. I really feel like this is all you. Show us how this person is feeling, please, Aries. Show us how Aries is currently feeling in love. Oh, you got three pop out. The Six of Swords in reverse, the Two of Cups, and the Nine of Cups. Oh, wow, Aries. Okay, you got a lot of Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy here. With the Six of Swords, in reverse, you going back to somebody. This was something that you maybe was a little toxic. Okay, this is Aquarius, Libra, Gemini energy. But you're going back to it with the Six of Swords in reverse. This is like the past is haunting you. And then you got the Two of Cups. So you have a soulmate connection with somebody. With the Two of Cups. That's destiny, soulmates, connection, love. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy. And then you got the Nine of Cups. This person is your wish fulfillment. All your cups are upright except the Six of Swords. So your energy is very good. You know what you want. It's not confusing at all. I feel like the more reverse cards somebody has, the more confusing they are a bit sometimes. Sometimes. Here, I feel like your energy is flowing. You know exactly what you want. You know exactly who you want. This person makes you happy. As a matter of fact, this King of Pentacles can be you, and this Nine of Pentacles could be the other person. Could be them being single, you watching them, how you see them, because the Two of Cups came up right under them. But the Nine of Cups is all about wish fulfillment, being happy, having what you want, having your wish. This is the wish card. Being content and being happy with it. Not only do you have your wish, but you're actually genuinely happy. This is genuinely pure happiness, the Nine of Cups. Look how this girl is smiling in the card. She's like, I got it all. I got what I wanted. Beautiful energy, Aries. Beautiful energy. Okay. You got the Seven of Wands in reverse on the bottom of the deck. That's not fighting no more. Maybe you've been fighting this. You previously were fighting this. Because you were Six of Swords maybe upright. And then you were leaving. You were going to walk away from this person. But you realize with this Two of Cups, there's something here. And with the Nine of Cups, I'm happy. This person genuinely makes me happy. How can I walk away? They want what I want. Okay, Nine of Pentacles is like the baby sister to the Empress. So you see this person as beautiful, sexy, extravagant, knowing how to manifest what they want. All right, let's see what your person is feeling. Show us this person that's dealing with Aries, how they're currently feeling, please. The person that Aries is thinking about, show us how they're feeling, please. The person that Aries is dealing with, show us how they're feeling currently about Aries. Show us how this person is currently feeling about Aries. Show us how this person is currently feeling, Aries. Oh, Aries. Be good to me. Hey. Ooh, we got a lot here. Okay, I'm going to take them all. All right, we got the Two of Wands in reverse. So this person is stagnant right now. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. Page of Cups. So they could have messaged you. Or maybe they want to message you, or they're going to come in and message you. This is Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy. Page of Cups is about a romantic proposal. Good news, a message of good news, of hope. Eight of Cups in reverse. This person is not walking away from you. This person tried to walk away too. This person tried to walk away from you too, Aries. They were Eight of Cups. They were trying to walk away from what wasn't serving them. But now they're coming right back. You're both mirroring each other. Five of Swords in reverse. Some type of fight you guys had. They want a resolution. That's Aquarius, Libra, Gemini energy. They want a resolution from that fight. They want peace. With the Five of Swords in reverse, that's all about resolving conflict. Okay? It's mentally exhausting. King of Cups. They love you. Holy shit. King of Cups. They love you. You could be dealing with a Scorpio for sure. If not Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Okay? Seven of Cups in reverse. Yeah, they know what they want. Y'all both know exactly what y'all want. That's deep. You both know that you want each other. The Seven of Cups in reverse, they feel like even if they may have options, the only thing they're really focusing on is you. I'm gonna tell you that right now. With them coming in as the King of Cups, and they in they shit. And that page is them too. First I saw them coming as a page. I'm like, why they coming in as a page? But no, they came in as the King, baby. Yeah, the Eight of Cups in reverse. We are constantly seeking restless and misguided, unwilling to risk journeying to uncomfortable places, facing up to the truth of what we have become as a result of our actions and choices, lack of self-love and compassion, neglect of physical body, and no discipline to still a racing, confused mind. I seek answers to life's big questions. That's what the Eight of Cups represents.
Okay, and then the Seven of Cups in reverse, imagination running wild, seeing danger and fear everywhere, believing the stories you imagine being true without proper questioning, being paralyzed by the intense multiplicity of possible options and paths you can take, allowing choice to fall into the hands of others or algorithms which do not have the best interests at heart. Beware of illusions. Okay, so I feel like this person is, I think they're a little bit scared right now. Because they're really fantasizing about you. They're thinking about you a lot, but nothing is happening. So it's fucking up their head. You know what I mean? It's fucking up their head. To the point that they're having, you know, hallucinations and fantasizing about you. But they're just really confused right now. They don't know what's what. All right. Let me try to find this. The Two of Wands in reverse. Two of Wands in reverse. Staying on the ground. Unwilling to gain perspective or move out of your comfort zone. Unable to see where you're going. Letting go of opportunities, launching too soon and unable to direct your gifts, being distracted and missing crucial information, no plan of action. Like I said, yeah, there's no action going on right now with this person. There's nothing going on with the Two of Wands in reverse. Okay, that's why they're having these illusions and they're scared that it's just it's a fake reality to them. They feel like it might just be, you know, fantasy because nothing's happening. Mm-hmm. King of Cups, compassionate and kind nature, dramatic and living grandiose, receive artistic success, belief in self and others. Okay? The King of Cups is like calm, creative, wise, a great inner strength, having joy, ease, no fear. Okay? King of Cups is fearless. All right? So I feel like that person's energy, I'm liking both of y'all energy. Y'all both, I mean, you're more like, y'all know what I want. Eight of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. Y'all both willing to work on this right now. Y'all both willing to work this out and work hard towards this and whatever this is. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. All right, so let's clarify some of these cards for you. Be good to me. Make sure you can see them. All my little crystals. Just being. It's crazy how that sage started smoking up, yo. That sage was smoking the fuck up, y'all. I don't know if y'all could see it on the camera. That shit was smoking the fuck up. All right. Just be good to me. All right, let's use the Morgan Greer to clarify, okay? This person definitely makes you happy, Aries, and you definitely know. Like, you're so confident in your energy. I love it. They're not so confident. I guess maybe because they maybe could have tried to come to you with that Page of Cups and you maybe denied it. Possibly. That's what I'm feeling. Hey. Oh. Hey. My channel is a cool channel. I'm not trying to be like some of these tarot readers that be mad boring or mad stuck up writing readings. Like, I'm just trying to talk to you like I'm your friend. Like, I'm not coming to you on no, you know what I mean? Like, I got my music playing. I got my shit. Like, I be busting out my candy. Like, I'm coming to you as your friend. I'm not coming to you as, oh, I'm Miss Cleo. I come to save the day. Like, I'm not on no stupid shit like that. You know what I mean? Like, if I do help you, that's wonderful. You know, but I'm coming to you like on some friendship. Not on no, you know, people want me to be something I'm not. Like, that's not me, sweetie. I'm not like all the other readers. I knew I wasn't going to be like them. And that's okay, because that's what makes me unique. All right, let's see. Why are you King of Pentacles? Show us this King of Pentacles, please, for Aries. Show us the King of Pentacles for Aries. So what's this King of Pentacles, please? Here it is. The Nine of Wands in reverse. Okay, you're a little paranoid, though. Huh. Eight of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. Again, from two different tarot decks, but you are going to work on this. But you are defensive. You are paranoid. You are kind of scared to come forward with that Nine of Wands in reverse. So, you're not there yet. Maybe you're not King of Pentacles yet, but you're going to be there. Or that's how you feel and that's what you want. But right now, you're a little guarded. All right, show me this King of Pentacles. Show me the King of Pentacles. Show me the King of Pentacles. The Ace of Pentacles. Oh, you want a new beginning with this person. Okay. Some coins up in this shit. I love it. Strength. You'll be dealing with a Leo. You're trying to get the courage to come forward with and bring forward this new beginning. That's what I'm strongly picking up. You're trying to get the courage to come forward and present this person with this new beginning, but you're very guarded. You're very scared. You're on the defense right now. But it's in you. You're right there, like you're like about to explode because you're right there. With King of Pentacles, the King of Pentacles comes to do, but he doesn't take risk. That's the thing about the King of Pentacles. He doesn't take risk. So maybe dealing with this person could be some type of a risk. Feel it's a risky type relationship. That's why you're taking your time. You're waiting. But you're going to come. Okay? And somebody got some money with all these pentacles. I love it. Yes. Show me this Nine of Pentacles, please. Yes. Am I getting some money in the new year? 2021. I see a lot of money for you, Aries. A lot of money. That's what the fuck I'm talking about. The Hierophant. Oh, you want to marry this person. Oh, could be dealing with a Taurus. You feel commitment. You feel a strong spiritual connection with this person. You feel committed to them. You feel that this person could offer you stability. That's deep. The Hierophant, you feel spiritually connected. You could be also talking to spiritual advisors about this person. You could be connecting with spirit to talk about this person. But you feel spiritually connected. The Hierophant is all about commitment and marriage. Five of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck in reverse. You and this person cannot be talking right now. And you want to come out of the cold. You want to come out of that. Whatever this is positive change. The Five of Pentacles in reverse. And more pentacles you got. Okay? More pentacles. More money. Show me this Nine of Cups, please. Ooh. The Ten of Pentacles. More money. Whew. You want... Yo, Aries. I'm loving your energy. You know what the fuck you want. The Ten of Pentacles on top of the Nine of Cups. You know that this stability with this person is going to make you happy. You know that this is your happy home. This is inheritance. This is family legends. This is generational wealth. This is a power couple. This is what you want with this person. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Energy. All over here. Wow. You got the Four of Swords at the bottom of the deck, though. So I feel like you're contemplating right now. You're not making these moves just yet, but this is what you're feeling. This is what you're feeling. You're contemplating right now. Show me the Six of Swords. Ooh. All right, there was some type of fight with this Five of Wands that just jetted out. Some type of conflict. So maybe some type of competition with this person. Maybe you feel like this person has a lot of people that want them. With the Six of Swords in reverse. Oh, there you go at the bottom of the deck. The King of Wands. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. But you're going to... This is the King of Wands comes to take control. The King of Wands is the initiator. When he presents himself, he's coming to initiate. He's coming to take action on something. So this is you taking action. I'm not even at your person. I'm seeing all you right now and your feelings. All right, show me this Two of Cups. Try that again. Let's shuffle. Spirit says shuffle again. This is deep right here. This is deep right here, Aries. I didn't even get to their side yet. Show me the Two of Cups, please. Okay, the Chariot in reverse. Okay, yeah. You're not doing anything right now, just like I said. The Chariot in reverse, you kind of want to come in forceful, but you're just trying to wait because it's like you're not grabbing the reins. You're not grabbing the wheel yet. You don't know how you want to come in and do this, how you want to bring this together. Could be dealing with a Cancer. You don't know how you want to come forward, okay? But you want to come forward, but there's no movement right now, okay? You feel like you invested in this a lot. That Eight of Pentacles again is coming out, but in reverse this time. Because again, nobody's doing anything. All right, nobody's doing anything. Six of Swords at the bottom of the deck in reverse again. That's the card. You got it twice from two different tarot decks. That is you. You're not leaving this person. You are turning right back around and going right back to them. Okay? Now let's see this person. Show me the Two of Wands in reverse. Show me the Two of Wands in reverse. They got Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy on their side. Didn't I just... Wow. The Six of Swords in the bottom of... The dude's just on the bottom of the deck for you in reverse. And now this person is getting it. You and this person are mirroring each other. You're both not leaving each other. Queen of Cups in reverse. This person could have been manipulative to you. They could be repressing their emotions. They could have been cold-hearted towards you. A bitch. Okay? Queen of Cups, that's Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces to be dealing with. Especially with all this cup energy on your side. This is definitely a water sign. You might have a lot of earth in your chart. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. All right? Show me this Princess of Cups. That's the Page of Cups. The King of Swords in reverse. Oh, yeah, you blocked out their offer. So I feel like this person sent you some type of message or made some type of romantic proposal to you in the past, and you declined it. You went silent on them. You did not answer. You did not respond. The Star card in the bottom of the deck. They were wishing, praying, hoping, believing. Aquarius energy right here. Praying that you guys come back together. This is crazy. Show me the King of Cups, please. Show me the King of Cups, please. The Six of Pentacles in reverse. They love you, but they feel like it's nothing's being reciprocated. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy right now. So that's why they're holding back their love. But Nine of Cups at the bottom of the deck, you make them intentionally, you make them happy. You both got Nine of Cups. Y'all are reflecting each other from two different tarot decks. You make them happy and they make you happy. You're their wish fulfillment. They're your wish fulfillment. What the fuck, Aries? Damn. Look how happy this person is in the picture. Show me the Seven of Cups. This is crazy. Show me the Seven of Cups in reverse. I love it. Show me the Seven of Cups in reverse, please. Ooh, the Devil. Oh, they feel attached to you than a motherfucker. With the on top of the Illusions card, they be fantasizing about fucking the shit out of you. That's Capricorn energy right there. They be fantasizing about you, Aries. Getting it on. Nine of Pentacles, they see you the same way as you see them. Wow. You see them as Nine of Pentacles, they see you as Nine of Pentacles. Single, beautiful, gorgeous, living life, making money, everybody wants you. This is the baby sister to the Empress. But with the Devil card, this person is addicted to you. They feel bound and attached to you. Could be some toxicity in the relationship. But on top of the Seven of Cups in reverse, they be having all types of fantasies and visions about you. They're bound to you. Show me this Eight of Cups in reverse. Ooh, that almost popped out. Show me this Eight of Cups in reverse. Okay, the Seven of Cups. So they got the Seven of Cups twice, upright and reverse. So I feel like with the Eight of Cups, they tried to walk away from you. Ace of Cups in reverse on the bottom of the deck. Unrequited love. Okay, loving somebody, feel like they don't love you back in return. Heartbroken, not able to let go of somebody from the past with the Ace of Cups in reverse. Okay. Eight of Cups with on reverse on top of the Seven of Cups. I feel like this person had a lot of options, but they know they want you. They had a lot of people come at them that were the wrong people. All this cup energy. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio for sure. I feel like they had a lot of people come their way that they just did not want. They just feel like you are their match. You know what I mean? Yeah, they feel like you are their match. I'm seeing all these things in reverse. People they don't want. They got a Knight of Cups in reverse. They got a Prince of Swords. They got Ace of Cups. They got love for you, though. There's mutual love here. And the Judgment card. That's having to make a choice. Show me the Five of Swords, please, in reverse. Let's take these. The Hermit and the... Oof. Wow. This person wants a new beginning with you. Okay? They want a new fiery beginning with you. They went through a spiritual transformation. That's Virgo energy there. And also Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. They went through a spiritual transformation. And now they want to... They feel horrible about what happened. Five of Cups. This is Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces energy. This is the Scorpio card. They feel horrible about what happened. They feel sad, regret, you know, grief over it. And, you know, they did a spiritual transformation. And they realize that you are what they want. You are the new beginning that they want, Aries. Okay, so I hope this helped you guys. If it resonated, please don't forget to like this video and leave me a comment. Let me know how it resonated. And I love you guys. Don't forget to subscribe and happy new year. Toodles.